E-Rev, apply directly to the forehead. E-Rev, apply directly to the forehead.
E-Rev is not responsible for any monitor to head-related injuries. View at your own risk.
Good evening and welcome to E-Rev TV, and tonight we're going to be covering some TGL Open playoffs here. This is the first round on MP Crash, and it's going to be, overrated, and now it looks like they're going to be called now Unrivaled Entertainment. Now, I didn't get the lowdown on this as they changed right into the midstream of this server here, so I'll try to get some information on that, and we'll get that to you. But it is overrated. That's who we have scheduled, but right now you will see Unrivaled Entertainment. They're going to be going up against the old, only the best, and which is now Team Housing, and I guess just the revolving door of name changes and players and such just never stop and never cease to amaze me. But I'm going to be your host tonight, Anger, and casting with me tonight will be From Housing / Only the Best, Smack. What's going on, bro?
Dude, what's going on, man? I'm doing awesome. Just munching on some hella greasy Chinese food. I'm feeling like a gamer right now, man. Ready to watch some action.
Wow, you sound like you're in the... Are you in the bathroom, bro? You sound really hollow, but you still kind of sort of sexy, but, you know, that kind of weird feeling. But never mind. It's all good, bro.
I'll try and step it up a notch for you, man.
And I can't believe he's in this channel, but he's coming back, back by popular demand. I have to bring him in as a free agent this time, so if anybody out there, no matter who it is, any team out there, he's probably going to kick my ass after I say this, any team out there that wants a free agent as sexy and as talented as this individual that I'm going to introduce, you need to hit him up. His name is The Impaler. What is going on, bro?
Banger. Oh, I hate you right now, buddy. What's going on? Glad to be back. Glad to cast some TGL Open, see some teams I've never seen before. It's going to be great.
Well, as I was saying a little bit earlier, you know, one of the questions I asked you before we went live on air was, caught you ever like this with the revolving door of team changes personnel and such like that? I mean, it's just, does it surprise you that it's so crazy like this in COD 4?
It's insane. I mean, the stability between teams is just ridiculous. There's, like, no loyalty to anyone or sponsors or anything. But I guess, you know, these teams want to be, the next big thing and get paid to go to LAN and everything. So they're going to take whatever sponsor they can get. And, you know, I don't blame them. But it's just crazy to see a new team with the same players I've seen before on a new name every day. It's just, it's ridiculous.
And we'll get into a little bit more details of housing as Smack knows the lowdown on that, since he is from that team. We'll get some little history on that, but I'm going to go over the starting lineups as it looks like everybody's ready except for Smack, so I want you ready up. For the Marine side, it will be housing. We have Furious, Madcap, Wasted Talent, we have Fallen, and Chode. That will be for housing. And for the off-force side, it will be Overrated / Unrivaled Entertainment. It will be Judas, Prospect, Invec, Wisdom, and the cutie himself, Ryan Twombly. So he's a sexy beast. So things are getting underway here as the two teams will get rocking and rolling here as shots being fired, but no one killed yet, but a lot of wasted bullets as Prospect takes out Wasted there with the 74, and Invec with the scope taking out Furious. So a little bit back and forth action, a little fast pace here off the start. And just like always here, Andy, the A bombsite will be the choice here. Very surprising if you see a B push, but then again, a lot of top teams like to go push B just to keep the defense on their heels, and do you think we might see this here tonight, Andy?
Well, you know, the A bombsite is always the popular bombsite of choice just because it's quickest to get to, but depending on the team's defensive nades, you know, you're going to see a lot of slow picks and maybe even a B push, but from what I'm seeing, Hawzen's having no trouble getting into the A site. Rive was lucky to get a guy in there and defend it, but you know it's a 1v2 situation right now, and if they're able to get in the bomb site past their nades like that, I'm going to see them running all over Rive tonight right into the A bomb site.
Well, right now we have Twombly gets lit up there by a nade. Nice job, my Madcap. So we're going to have a little 1v1 here between Madcap and Invec. So if you remember, Invec used to be on Nexus back in the days, I believe in Season 1. So we're going to take a look at him as Madcap does get the plant down. A little 1v1 action as Invec moves up the stairwells here in the A bomb site. He's working against the 35-second clock here as they're going back and forth. Madcap deagles him to death there. Takes out Invec, so Hazen will take an early 1-0 lead. Smack, I know that you started out with only the best, and they got picked up here by Hazen. Talk really quick here how that took place.
Only the best. I'm sure some of you are familiar with them from Season 1 in Cal. They didn't make it through the playoffs, taking out Banff by a score of 13-2, actually. And, you know, lately they've been performing really well, and, you know, not to toot my own horn or anything, but we had a couple options. There was Madcast looking at us, ended up deciding to take the one from Housen, as Madcast was taking a while to make their decision. Not sure on the lowdown on that, as I am a lowly scrim starter. And but yeah, they just decided to take on Housen, get some servers, some website hosting, and some vent for free.
All right. Well, we're going to get back to the action here as Madcap with the bomb here, moving in between outside their spawn. And he's going to have a tough task here. He's going to be going up against three Rive members, Twombly, Prospect, and Invex. So this is going to be a tough task here, and let's see if Madcap can do it as he's making his way to the B alley. And wow, he takes out Twombly there as Twombly was peeking a little too much there as his head just got ripped off his shoulders there. So Madcap trying to even it up here. A little 2v1 action now as we're going to take a look at Invec moving around. Looks like he's going to rotate and possibly Well, nope. He's moving back to the towards the crash site. We have Prospect in the same vicinity there, and there he does. He takes out Madcap with the 74. So things are even up 1-1. Just like always, we're gonna have to do some war room here, and we're gonna head on over to Overrated / Rive now. So let's go there.
I got B. I got B too.
One E for sure.
Mid crash. One rush tub. Light. Bottom light. Going up top.
On top blue.
What? Adam, he came in.
Dead. One's near the ladder and top light.
I'm gonna flank them, B alley.
Sniper top blue. One B, B plant.
Think so?
Top blue.
Sandbags.
All right, back to live action here as Furious cleans things up and Housen goes on to a 2-1 lead. And just in case you don't know, some of you guys may not be familiar with these teams. Let's talk about how they got here. We have Overrated coming in at a 6-2 record throughout the season, and they're coming in at a rank of number 24. And Housen coming in at 7-1, very impressive record, coming in at the number 9 rank. So this is how the two teams got here. And right now, Setney's getting off, but Twombly getting one on Wasted. And Andy, you can tell those people out there, the set nade's really key on this map, because I know some maps, they're really, really super-duper key on this map. Is that the same?
Oh, yeah. I mean, especially on this map, considering the fact that they're pushing people out of the A-bomb site on defense and on offense. I mean, as you saw around previous, Rive was unable to rush or to get into their own bomb site because of the offensive nades. And that round right there, Housen had to go slower because of the fact that Rive was keeping them out with nades of their own. So it's really a situation where if a team has good nades, you're just going to get down to picks. And it looks like what we're seeing now is just a rush from Housen going right down to the B bomb site. It's going to be like Fallen having the bomb, taking out somebody at the truck, moving up to the bomb site. He's just going to, you know, kind of hang out down here, wondering what's going on around him. He hears people all around, but it doesn't look like... he's getting good communication from his teammates because they've spotted somebody going to the B bomb site. I can't even pronounce that name. I don't know what's wrong with this guy. He's got a 1 and a 4 in his name. This is ridiculous. But he's going to be prone under the truck here waiting for a B plant, and he's going to come up on, take out Fallen, and he's going to be defending this bomb site, and we're going to see if Rive can hold the bomb now that they know where the bomb is down. Madcap's going to be pushing up with the M4. I don't know why on earth he's using this gun. But, you know, whatever, to each his own. He's going to spot someone up there in that top spawn house, and in this 3v1, I do not see Madcap coming out just because of the fact that he has an M4 and a sniper. Oh my god, this is absurd. I don't know what's wrong with this guy. He has a star in his name. It's insane. He's going to peek around for a bit now, though. But Vizhack, I guess that's his name, and Invec just have the whole site on lock, and you have Packet watching the turnaround, and Visak's going to get the kill with his 1-4 in his name. He's just a championship player.
Yeah, that is Judas there. Changes his name. So right now it is 3-2 in the favor of Rive, and Rive coming out strong these last two rounds. And Housen's trying to switch up the strats a little bit here. They've actually committed to the B bomb site and trying to get through that B alley, but they're getting choked off as Rive is making a counter push and coming in with their defense to prevent them from even possibly getting that plant down. And they're doing the same here as Wisdom gets takes out Furious with a nice nade placement there, and Madcap again with the asterisk at the end of his name, and he is pro. As Andy was saying here, trying to get possibly a scope shot, possibly someone peeking out. As, wow, Prospect, nice double kill there, taking out Fallen and Chode. And Wisdom cleaning things up, taking out Madcap. And now, again, Rive gets another team ace there, and they extend their lead to 4-2. So we're going to head on over to Housen. Let's see what they're talking about in their vent. Let's do their war room.
Wow. What's your nade?
One down A.
Library roof.
Down bottom A.
One through roof on hardware.
Nice.
Come on, go, go, go.
Holy shit.
Where's he
sandbag.
At?
Mega. He's sandbag, I believe.
There's smoke.
Alright, I got stairs. Someone watch bottom. Got him.
There you go.
Yeah, baby.
Alright, House, it gets
nice
back
job,
on the
guys.
Board here. 4-3, and I mean, Smack, you saw that. Look a little like martyrdom there. A little nade there picking up that last kill.
Yeah, man. A couple things I'm noticing so far off the bat. First of all, wasted talent on the Housen side. He's usually very successful pushing through the middle, but this Riot team has just been able to shut him down. And I think that's really been very influential so far in the match, as he is a very talented SMG player. And he's just really been shut down by the defense of this Riot team. But another thing that you'd want to mention is that the Housen team right now is currently on the harder side. If they can pick up a good 3 or 4 more rounds on this side, they are in very good shape to go into the op 4 side, which is currently the easy side, as we are in a 1-on-4 situation right now in favor of Housen.
Yeah, Prospect, the last man standing, he gets taken out there by Wasted with the 74, so you're absolutely right there, as Housen right now is going to tie everything up, so this is looking good for them, at least right now, these last two rounds. So everything tied up, and we're going to take a look at the EREV scoreboard right now. We have Madcap going 6-5, and we have Fallen going 6-6 for Housen. For the Rive / Overrated side, we have Judas going 7-5, and we have Wisdom going 6-6. So Wasted there, taking out Prospect right off the start there. As wow, Judas getting taken out, Fallen, and Envek taking out Fury. So again, back and forth here. Envek right now for Overrated is very key at that B alley, as he's probably going to flank. Nope, he's going to go right into the mid area. Smoke being deployed around him in the mid area as Wasted now getting in the prone position. So right now we have Wisdom and Envek going up against Wasted and Madcap. Madcap with the bomb making his way into the A bomb site. Is this looking good for Housen right now, Andy, as they're making their way into the A bomb site?
I mean, Housen's just straight up taking control of that A bomb site. They're getting a guide down at A from nades or anything else during the beginning seconds of the round, which is good for them, and then they're just pushing into the site. I mean, anything from 4 to 6 rounds on offense is great on this map, and if they happen to get any more than 6 rounds, I see this being a quick match for Team Housen.
Well, there it is there, as we have Overrated getting taken out. So Housen coming up 5-4. They overtake the lead here, so nice job by them. We're going to head on over to Overrated's war room once again. So let's take a ride there, Limey, to their war room.
Russian crap.
One lore.
Top blue.
One
oh my god.
Still.
How'd you get there?
Outside
one
blue,
A,
top blue.
Two blue.
Okay, we need to get at least 6, so.
Alright, back to live action. 6-4 here, and Housen extends the lead, and they're looking really juicy here as we head getting close to that halfway mark. 6-4 again with this team. And anything surprising you since we've, you know, pretty much seen what the strats are here, Andy?
No, I mean, I'm just surprised that Rive is giving up A that quickly. They haven't really made any adjustments to that bomb site. Still sending the same two in Prospect and VizHack to that bomb site. And they're basically letting Housen walk right in. They're throwing the same nades they've been throwing and not really holding that bomb site down. As Fallen is actually going to get taken out now, and Rive has actually begun to do something. They pushed Twombly through middle, and he was able to get a couple kills. And, you know, they need to bring this to 6-6, or I'm just going to call this right now in favor of Housen, because letting them go into that bomb site is a mistake.
Yeah, they're going to probably catch up here. They got really a lot of ton of momentum here, as we're going to take a look at Housen off the start. Now, they should keep going to A, but now it looks like they're changing things up, and they're making a full commitment to the B bomb site. They're getting through the B alley right now, and Twombly right now trying to flank, and oh, there he is. He takes out Fallen, but he gets raped there by Chode. Madcap cleaning things up, taking out, oh, he takes out his own member, Chode, there, through that whole firefight as Prospect takes out Furious. That's not looking good. Housen was looking juicy there, getting to the B bombsite, but with the TKs and just not getting things straight there towards the B bombsite, that gave Rive that round, and that could be very, very key there, Andy, 6-6.
Yeah, like I said, that was a big round, but now Rive has to come on the other side and go ahead and get as many rounds as possible, you know, and depending on Hausen's defense, if they play, you know, better defense than Rive did, I just see them taking this match. This is, like Smack said, the easy side of the map, and any kind of change that they need to make that needs to happen now for Hausen to just come in and take this thing. And I'm not going to ready it up because I just don't like it.
All right, Smack, you know Housen's, I don't want you to say they're strat on the defense, but how are they going to look on this map on the defense? Are they pretty solid on this side, bro?
Well, one thing you're going to want to look for with this Housen team is you're going to want to look at the nades. I mean, I can't say, you know, too much here, but obviously those nades, I know for a fact, are going to be very deadly, or at least they should be, and you're going to see a lot of good SMG work up the middle from Wasted, as it looks like he has started to pick things up since I started saying things about him. As Fallen takes out Twombly with that 74U in the A site, and he gets taken out by Imbeck in turn.
Well, right now we have Madcap, the last man standing for this Team Housen, and he's moving into the A bomb site. Imbeck gets the plant down, so if it's Wisdom and Imbeck, you have the clock to work against here, so just the extra member here, and there it is there. Imbeck takes out Madcap with the 74, so they're going to get the lead here 7-6, as right now we have Rive looking really, really good here, and hopefully they can keep this going. If not, Housen really needs to do some work here. So we're going to take a look at Rive here, and Andy, let's see if they're going to do a typical strat here on the offensive side.
Well, it's looking like they're just rolling with the same kind of thing, pushing into that A bomb site, and it worked for them last round. What they're attempting to do is get a pick somewhere and then send their SMG in that direction, which it looks like they have gotten a pick at A, and they are now sending their SMG into the bomb site. And Twombly just doing an amazing job with the M4, and I'm impressed because it's by far the worst gun I've ever seen in my entire life. And he's gonna get the plant down, but get naded by Madcap, who is holding his nade like a nerd every round and cooking it into the bomb site. And Hausen is gonna make a push back into the back of the bomb site. Madcap once again going in with his deagle in hand. See someone on the stairs and gets taken out by Invec. It's going to be a 2v1 in favor of Rive. You have Hausen, I think that's Frizz, or I don't even know, Furious? I think it's Furious. Yeah, I'm going to go with Furious. That makes sense. And Invec and Prospect for the Rive squad. And Prospect's just going to be sitting watching backwood while Invec has... They have the best setup that they could right now, watching both sides of the stairs, trying to defend themselves. Furious knows where Prospect is, and Vex's going to work up the backwood stairs, going to fire into Furious and just get taken down. It's going to be Prospect versus Furious, 1v1, bomb down. We have 1 second. He's just going to get knifed right in the face. He got gutted, that's it. Didn't have a chance.
Oh, he pulled out the hemorrhoids and everything. They're hanging to the ankles, 8-6 here.
They're just dominating offense, which is what they need to do, because if Hausen cannot adjust, this is going to be a quick one, because they're doing the same thing. Like I said, they're getting a pick, and then they're moving to whatever site they're picking on.
Well, we're going to take a look here at Hausen. Let's see how they can adjust here by this onslaught that Rive is giving them. And really, Madcap is hanging out in the B bomb site as the scope, so they may want to go with another assault or something of that nature here to really even it up, because I don't see a scope here from the Rive side as I'm bouncing around. So that might be a key thing to change up there, as right now we have Wiz in the blue room. We have Prospect now in the A bomb site. Cho taking out Twombly. So it's going to be 3v2 here. The one-man advantage going to Rive right now. The bomb just laying it into that vicinity. Prospect looks like he's going to pick that up. And Chode for Housen is capping the bomb, just laying right on top of it and making sweet love to it as the flash is... Oh, nice flash there. Picks up the bomb. Madcap takes out Prospect as it's back and forth here. Wisdom is the last man standing here for Rive. He's going up against Chode and Madcap. And Smack, this is looking good. At least a one-man advantage, at least, for Housen here.
Yeah, and you know, I'm really getting surprised here because my team is just sort of getting picked in back A. But, you know, a lot of the things we've been noticing is the nade kills, once again, you know, those are really important. If you can get those first one or two kills, you've got a huge advantage going into this round. And, you know, this Rive team is actually looking surprisingly strong on the offensive side, which, of course, is the harder side of the map. And, yeah, I'm surprised that Hausen isn't changing up their strat a little bit, giving Madcap a assault or an SMG and having him push into A, because that's really where they're just getting taken down right now.
Yeah, it's 8-7 right now in the favors of Rive, and they're still, right now, they're too, oh my goodness, they got really raped there in this round as Hausen doing a nice job. They stepped up their defense there, Andy, as Rive just got taken out. So we have Judas right now, the last man standing for Rive right now. So it's not looking good thus far here, as it's going to be a little a 4v1 action here.
Well, what they did was Hausen decided to change something up. They sent two guys middle, and they just pressured the four guys, count them, four from Rive that were sitting in Blue House. And Fallen's going to get the kill into Vizhak, or Judas, whatever his name is. I don't like it. And if they keep playing, if they keep putting pressure, I see it being a tough bout on offense for Rive. But they cannot sit back. They have to keep the pressure up, because Rive cannot handle that pressure right in their face. But if they're going to let Rive pick, then I see Rive coming out with this one. And as you see again, early nades. Fallen getting a double nade.
Wow.
Deuces on kids. Being insane, it's going to be Prospect versus three members of the Hausen squad. I just said squad. Man, I feel like a nerd. And Prospect going down at the hands of Furious.
Wow, talk about a role reversal there, Andy and Smack. I mean, 9-8 here, and Hausen is just lighting up the board here, and those set nades are very, very key. I mean, is it? If I was Rive, I would try to switch things up a little bit. It looks like Hausen has adjusted to the A site very well, and they're doing good. Would you want to go B on this one, Andy, just to change things up, even though you have Madcast with the scope?
I'd want to do something different, because this sitting back thing, if they're going to keep getting pressured, it's not going to work. They've basically already figured out that, you know, Hausen's figured out that if they pressure Rive, they're going to be able to take these rounds. And if Hausen's going to keep playing the same game, they're just going to keep getting dominated. They need to find something in the rush, and they need to do it quick, or they're going to be going home early.
Yeah, I apologize. I said Madcap. It's Madcap, so as I'm talking really fast there. Right now we have a Prospect there taking out the Chode. So Madcap right now, the last man standing, as he's in the A bomb site. He's going to have to go up against Prospect, Wisdom, and Inbeck. So not very... Oh, he does take out Prospect as he got shot in the back there. So now 2v1 here. That's being fired from the top wood. Oh, just a... put him up in a crossfire there as Inbeck takes takes him out there with a 74. So everything tied up 9-9. And right now we're going to head back to Hausen's War Room. Let's go there now, Limey.
Those guys.
I got
A. Gosh. At the pillars, falling.
One's going top blue.
Bullshit.
God.
One's B alley.
Well, B alley.
Mid crash.
And banana.
Wow.
I'm so fucked.
All right, 10-9 now as Rive gets the lead back. So just like a classic boxing match there, just punches being delivered from both sides, back and forth. And when you think you have a team on the ropes, just a little rope-a-dope, and now the other team is on the same rope. So again, back and forth here, Andy. And as you're seeing this, is this going to be a tough one to call? Who would you call on this to come out as the victor?
Right now, I'm going to say Rive, because of the fact that Hausen has given up on their strategy to push up on them. I mean, pushing up was working. It worked three rounds in a row, and they have just stopped doing it. I don't know what they decided to do. I don't know if somebody fell asleep on the strat calling, but they're now playing back, and they're just getting picked apart. As you can see, Twombly just running all over the place. He ran up middle last round and killed two, and this round, they're just letting him get picked, and that cannot happen, especially from an SMG. As it's going to be a 1v4 situation in favor of Rive, and Wasted, or I think it's...
Yeah, Wasted.
Oh, I don't even know his... I'm really bad at these names. I'm going to have to give a bunch of chat casting. But it's going to be a 3v1 in favor of Rive, Waste of Talent moving up to the bomb site. Gonna get taken out by Wiz, and as you can see, sitting back is not the thing to do. They need to get into this and rush. If they are not going to rush, they are just going to be done, and that's gonna be that.
Yeah, you have Rive just pushing out, and once they do a lot of flanking and it's really giving Housen some problems, so they kind of counter-reacted to what Housen was doing at A, and you're exactly right, Andy. They really halted their push here and really applying pressure to Rive, and now Rive is just running all over them here. But right there, Wasted takes out Wiz with the AK, so a little 5v4 action, the one-man advantage going to Housen. And as Fallen's going to be holding down the A bomb site, Twombly again just running crazy here. He picks up a kill, and then we have Judas taking out Furious. So again, it's going to be 3v2 here, and Rive again with the man advantage. And they seem, as the round gets a little bit deeper, they get the advantage, and they're doing the same here. As right now, we're going to take a look at Prospect in the mid area, or actually the A area outside of the by air conditions, and he's moving into that possibly that bomb site right now. He's getting some shots fired there, going 1v1 now. Takes out Fallen through the wall there, a little wall banging there as he takes him out with the 74. So Prospect and Invec going up against Madcap, and Madcap with the D go out. He's over by the B bomb site. Oh, we have Invec putting the plant down. He didn't kill him. And oh my God, Invec takes out Madcap. What the hell? Oh my God. Invec with the knife. 12-9 now, as this could be possibly the final round here, Andy.
Just like I said, I mean, they're playing back, they're getting pushed, they're not able to handle it. Housen has got to change his defense, and it doesn't look like they are doing it this round. They've only sent one A, and it's looking like the same thing. As Wasted Talent's going to get two kills, but still, I mean, the way that they're playing is not a good setup on this map. I do not understand why they're going to play back when it has worked so many rounds with the push-up. It's just... It's insane. It doesn't make any sense to me. But, you know, these are the lower tier teams, so I would expect them to do something different. But you're going to see a 3v3 situation in Vec, Wiz, and Prospect versus Chode, Madcap, and Wasted Talent. Madcap is going to have that scope looking into bottom A, and that's really going to be, you know, probably the factor here. If he can get a key pick right now, we're going to see something different. As Wasted Talent pushing up, going up the B alley, getting taken out by Wiz. It doesn't make any sense to me, Anger. They're pushing up. They have the bomb sites. They're just making bad decisions right now.
Well, now finally they get onto the bomb site, Invec, and they're very surprised to see that because, you know, we know Invec. But as we're looking here, and there it is there, Chode getting lit up there by Invec. So Madcap, the last man there, standing for this Housen team. And again, they're probably going to have to scratch their head here, Smack, as they could have made some simple adjustments and really given Rive some problems here, but they just couldn't quite do it. And, you know, you may want to talk to them about that and, you know, see what happens if they can change things up. Because, again, they're probably going to be kicking themselves in the ass after watching the archive on this one.
Yeah, I'm also fairly surprised at how... Madcap picking up two Deagle kills right here. We'll see if he can hold this. It could possibly... No! Oh, wow.
GG's
good games all around. But yeah, I was very surprised at how the Housen team didn't really pick up so many rounds on what is supposedly the easier side of this map. And, you know, also going along with what Andy was saying... you know, they really didn't push mid enough. They didn't get in their face, and it really worked for a lot of rounds for them. And I think, you know, one or two rounds after they started doing that, they might have gotten detonated a few times, decided to back off, played a little bit safer, and I think that might have been their downfall.
Yeah, absolutely there, as we're going to try to get some players from Overrated / Rive, as again, they changed their name midstream there. But we'll get them going. So... you can get your shout-outs across the airwaves here at @e-rev on the Game Surge Network. You can definitely hit up myself, Anger, or Smack. And I'm not sure, Impaler, are you in the E-Rev IRC channel?
I am not on IRC because you sold me out earlier, and I don't want PMs from 101st Airborne Division. Thank you very much.
Classic. Hey, they're a pretty good team. They're up and coming there, Andy. You know, you never know. A couple 12-packs they'll give you. All right, man. I swear you never cease to amaze me. You're a classic, dude. Anyway, I'm going to get some shout-outs here. Well, Smack, do you have any shout-outs by any chance, bro?
I've got one from a teammate of mine, Pokeef. He wants to give a shout-out to Fallen and the guys. Nice try. It's the first time we didn't rush that map, and I guess it really didn't work out for him, but nice tries all around.
All right. Here, I'll get, let me, Limey, if we could take a real quick break, I'm going to try to get a hold of Rive right now, and we can do that. So give us about 5 minutes, ladies and gents, or so, or a little less than that, and we'll get you a live interview here and some information. If you're in IRC, you can read the article in Gottfrag, and it'll kind of give you an idea of what I'm going to talk about really quick. So just hang on. We'll be back in a couple minutes, and we'll get you an interview. So hold on.
Hey, this is Logan Badfish Null from Phoenix.
Hey, this is Prank from Team Pandemic.
Hey, this is Mike JTS2MP from Team Dirty Bird.
Hey, this is Hipshot from DNO, and you're watching EREV.
EREV, don't just watch it, get into it.
This is Hazen's only good player, Moores.
This is Mike Zulia Sepsi from Powerhouse Gaming.
Yo soy Matt Shinpei Gomez, del equipo de Hexamon Gaming.
And it's the Queen that we call it.
Hey, this is Chuck Prep White from Team DRT.
Hi, this is Salvador from 50 Cal, and you're watching EREV TV.
EREV, don't just watch it, get into it.
Salut, c'est François Joufflu Lortie de Final Destination.
Hey, this is Big Tuck, Baby Chase Tucker from 50 Cal.
This is Rob SSR Myers from Frag Dominant.
Hey, this is Brett from Team Guardian.
Hey guys, this is Nabor from Team Pandemic, and you're watching EREV TV.
EREV, don't just watch it, get into it.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. As we're getting the Rive members in here, we're going to try to get all five starters as they're making their way into our event. In the meantime, I'll get a quick shout-out here from Fluke. Shout-out, good game to both teams. Good luck, have fun. Make babies in the next round, Rive. That is from Fluke. So we're going to get the rest of the guys in here as I'm going to try to move them down. All right, looks like we're going to pull the rest of these cuties in here. All right, ladies and gents, we have all five starters here from Rive or Overrated. We'll get to that here as you guys changed on us in midstream. But first off, congratulations as you move into the next round there. Good job, guys. And how do you feel coming off this win, Twombly?
I'd have to say, you know, as a whole, we played extremely well. You know, we had to kind of change things up mid-match. Some of our previous strats didn't work out the way we wanted to, but on the run, I say we did a really good job.
All right. We have Twombly, Wisdom, Prospect, Judas, and Invec in here live in the channel. And one of the things here, I know you're going up against Housen here. You know, they were used to be only the best, and they're with their new name change. Did you know much about this team coming into it? I'm sure you knew a few players, of course, Furious, and probably a couple others. But what were you guys expecting from Housen? I'm sure you guys screamed it in the past. Was there something that you were really looking at possibly to exploit on them and take advantage on maybe possibly their defense or something? Twombly?
Well, we noticed as far as, you know, their A was actually pretty strong at the beginning as for offense was concerned. So that's why we started working like a mid and B type of push. We had a few good nades in the beginning, a few good picks, which really allowed us to push as a team and take over B-bomb site or even work back to A if we needed to.
Let me ask you this. I know in the middle rounds there, when you're on offense, it looked like you guys got kind of pushed around. Well, I mean, Andy noticed this at the start. It looked like Housen was being really aggressive there, and they picked up a few rounds on you guys. Were you surprised that they kind of pulled back a little bit and gave you guys the momentum that you needed to push wherever you needed to in those later rounds when you were on offense?
Yeah, I mean, I noticed off the start they pushed us pretty fast. Like they had a guy coming up middle, which, you know, we didn't even expect at all. None of the teams we played practicing for this match did anything like that, and that really caught us off guard. You know, we started countering it with nading the middle, smoking it, kind of, you know, making him play into our game, which then allowed us to make our picks and push where we wanted to.
Now, Wisdom, I know that they had a Madcap scoping at the B bomb site. When you're on offense, when you guys lost a few rounds there, did you guys actually contemplate on going B even though you knew there was a scope waiting there in the B alleys?
Yeah, I think that was the plan. Switch it up from A since A wasn't working with their flashes and that crazy nade that exploded right out of blue. Just to switch it up.
Right. Well, Andy, I mean, I don't know if you have any questions for these guys, but if you do, go ahead, shoot it off, bro.
No, I'm just going to say congratulations are in order. You guys did a very good job adjusting to the way they were playing. That middle adjustment, I guess, worked for you guys. They just ended up pulling that guy back, which was able to give you guys the win. A lot of good adjustments on your part on both the offensive and defensive sides, and you guys deserve the win, and I hope to see you further in the tournament.
Thanks a lot, guys, and great casting, and thanks for doing it for us.
Yeah, absolutely. Smack, do you have any questions, bro?
I think
looks like he's lagged out a little bit there.
With the double venting, how we managed to win.
All right, before we let you go, we're going to give each of you an opportunity to get some shout-outs over the airwaves. So we'll start with you and Beck first. If you have anybody, I don't know, any sponsors or friends or anything of that nature, go ahead and get that out right now, bro.
Well, I'd like to give a little shout-out to my best friend, Adam. You know who you are. You're listening here. And we don't have any sponsors, so... go team.
All right, and Judas, why don't you go do your thing, bro?
I'd like to thank the members that didn't get to play today for filling in during the scrimmage and cheering us on. Thanks, Pierce. That goes to you.
Now you're really low there, bro. You might want to turn it up. If you can turn it up a little bit, Judas, we'll come right back to you. And Prospect, what do you got, bro?
I'd just like to say thank you to Pierce for riding the pine. We're not very good at this game, but keep coming around for scrims because we never have five on. So that's about it.
All right, Wisdom, go ahead, bro.
Yeah, shout out to Pierce. Play Dota in a minute. And to Nova for being a complete fag.
All right, love to get those fag blasts out there. All right, Twombly, before I get your shout-outs, why don't you talk to us about how you guys switched to Rive? Is this official? Are you guys making a comeback under the Rive umbrella, or is this just a little play there?
Well, I talked to Dell, the gentleman in charge of Rive, and he told us that we were more than welcome to use the name, and we actually we didn't really want to use the name Overrated anymore because we didn't really live up to that, so... We decided we'd just try and find a new name until we can find an organization that wants to actually sponsor us, and Rive just kind of popped out to everybody as a good choice.
All right. Well, why don't you get your shout-outs live over there, Twombly. As you absolutely know, you're a cutie and a sexy beast, as I met you over at GigaFrag, but we won't talk about that because what happens there stays there, bro.
Yeah, well, first and foremost, I have to, hold on. All right. First and foremost, I have to say that Logan is my only lover. Sorry to all the single gentlemen out there, but he's my only person for me. And I'd have to say that JTF2 comes up with the best non-Frenchy nades in the game. And I have to thank him for the nades for Crash.
All right. Well, you may have to fight Starbuck for the love or for the heart of Logan, because you may have to fight him in his frosted hair. So keep that in mind, Twombly, as you'll be fighting out for that piece of man meat there. So, all right, guys, we appreciate you guys coming by. Again, congratulations as you guys beat Team Housen 13-9 as you move on to the next round of the TGL Open Playoffs. So thanks for coming by, guys.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Thanks.
All right, we're going to get things going here. Once again, we're going to go through some shout-outs. We have one here. I believe it's Berserk. I'm going to take a guess on that, a stab here, BZR double K. Shout-out says, good game to Housen, and he still thinks they can pull together in different leagues. I'm not sure exactly what he's stating there, but good games to both teams. That is from Berserk from BL. We have one here from Dittoho. Wow. Ditto, what's going on, cutie? From Main Gear, shout-out to my team, Main Gear, and my boy Mercy from Seraphic for making CVOP. And also he's giving a shout to Jesse also. So that is from Dittoho. We have one here from, let's see here. We have one here, last but not least, from Logan. Shout out, say Logan, say congrats to my bro Landon dropping his first 35 bomb at 30 frames per second. So that is all the shout outs I have. I don't know if you have any more, Smack or Andy, did you pick up, or you don't have your stuff on. So Smack, did you pick up any last minute ones?
Smack's mic doesn't look like it's going to be working. I don't know what's going on over there.
And
you must
have
be smacking it. You get it? Smacking it.
Rubbing one out.
I'd like to give a shout out to the fish, my boy the fish, the bad fish over at Mob Gaming. He is the cutest man in tight pants. That's private inside joke that you probably will never hear. But all the guys at Mob Gaming, everybody over there, Team Focal, Starbuck, Tyler, my boy Crafter, everybody on the internet, you're all nerds and I love you. It's great to be a fat gamer.
All right. One thing before we let this go, if you guys are in IRC, I posted the an article in Godfrag. Take a look at it. It pretty much self-explanatory right there, but we are putting on a big tournament, so hopefully we can get all the support from you guys. It's pretty much Wansum's baby, so I'll let him explain to it when we get him on the air in this next cast. So just a little heads up on that, so show some support from that as we're trying to do stuff for the community. And, of course, Andy is giving his full support on this, and he's going to be helping out on the AC side. So we thank you, Andy, definitely on that, bro. And as you know, you play COD 2. You had the survival of the fittest. How would this help the community doing this next this new tournament here, Andy?
Oh, any tournament, especially online for all the nerds that don't want to go to LAN. But any tournament that gives support to the game is great. And something like this ran by EREV, who are, you know, some of the main supporters with your shoutcasts and everything. It's just going to be a great time. Everybody's going to have a good time. And it's going to bring out a lot of competitive streaks in all different forms of the game and all different teams, because you're going to see a great, great drive for teams that want to play and that want to win some money. And I think this is great for the game, and it's going to bring the North American community up tenfold.
Yeah, and one of the good things about it is that we do have the invited teams, but once we get those locked in, it may be 16, it may be 17, give or take, but once we open up the rest of the slots to make up the full 32, it gives teams that are Cal Open, TGL Open, SIBO A, or even, just no-name teams an opportunity to pay and get your name across the airwaves and really make a name for your team, because you could upset a team. Who knows what's going to happen? It's going to be a double elimination. But nevertheless, I mean, you can get your name out there and really do some things and show your show everybody what your team's about. So, get on out there. Details will be coming up soon, more details. And, just support it, as we're going to try to give you the best in COD 4. So we'll try our best here. So for myself, Anger, Limic. Oh, Limic, I know you have a plug for Pro Gaming TV. Why don't you do that, bro?
ProGamingTV.com plugged. That's about it.
All right. Again, I appreciate Limic for coming in, doing this last minute. I appreciate that, bro, from Canada. As I forgot to introduce you, as I was getting thrilled that Andy was in this cast and being involved, I just got a hard one as a rock, so I'm going to rub this one out because I don't want to waste it. But for myself, Anger, Limic, Andy, and Smack with the broken mic now, I'd like to say good night as Overrated/Rive beats Teamhausen 13-9. So until our next cast, which would probably be, Thursday or Sunday or so, catch us. Check our site out for the latest schedule, or go to ProGamingTV.com for the latest and greatest. So until then, adios.
EREV, apply directly to the forehead. EREV, apply directly to the forehead. EREV is not responsible.